Don't leave me. Don't leave me, Tamika. Oh, that's better. like that smash button. Thank you, Mr. Wrangler.
Smash
button. Saved it. We always forget to turn the sound off because you get reverb echo, don't you?
We do.
Mm.
Yeah.
Goes, hello, hello, hello. How are we all going? Where are we in the world? Please let me know. I love to hear it from all ends of the earth. Hey, Alan, how you doing? The Oklahoma, that'd be Oklahoma, would that not be? Nancy, good to see you again. Love it, love it, love it. Shane, Melissa, good to see you guys. This is really cool. Yes, well, actually, Thanks, Nancy. That was very kind of you. We love our tacos, that is for sure.
I brought lunch that I don't really want today, so maybe maybe some tacos are on the cards.
Would you believe it that I brought fish tacos for lunch? We actually made fish tacos with the fish we caught last night, which was very, very yummy. Very cool. Oh, nice. From Wales. I've got family in Wales in the UK. Very cool. Hello to my family over there. We did a video last week. Most of you probably have seen it. Maybe some of you haven't. And I asked you what pattern was in the stone that I cut out of that nice piece. And while many of you did get it right, there's quite a few that still didn't get it right. So we're going to make another pattern video a little bit clearer, a little bit more...
Detailed,
in the future, coming soon, that will help you all understand patterns. So when I do ask you, you answer the right one, because it's not really that hard. You're equating a pattern with something that goes on, or some kind of feature in our life
that exists in the real world
that we know of.
Mm.
For instance, chaff pattern is a bear scratch, or it's a total claw that looks like five or four or even three lines that goes through a stone. That's chaff pattern, and we'll make it really clear for you to understand those types of patterns. Some of us didn't quite get it right, but plenty of you got a love heart, and anyone who did get a proper love heart, I love you. I love you all anyway, so it doesn't matter. Hi, Darren Swan, nice to see you here. And thanks, Don, for being there early and asking people to like and subscribe. You're a legend. And very cool. What else is happening? We are going to be going on holiday soon. So this is our second last live for the year.
Yep.
There'll be a video next week.
Video next week, yep.
With a twist. It's going to be a cool video.
It's a cool video, yeah.
Shane, thank you very much. That was very kind of you.
Oh.
So quite a different type of video next week. It's a very nice big piece, big chunk of 80 carats worth of seam opal with a red bar going right through it. So it's pretty exciting, but you won't believe what we cut out of it. So keep an eye out for that one. That's going to be a bit of fun.
We should have some videos over the holidays too.
So I have some videos of some stock that I've got that I've cut, and I've videoed them all. Rubbing them out. So over the holidays, you'll get to see just some pretty good rubbing out videos that I've put together. Don't touch that comment. Cutting videos.
Cutting videos. Yeah. Cutting and polishing. I don't know if we told. Oh yeah, we did tell everyone that you were going to Tucson for trade and retail.
Yes, we're going to Tucson this year. I'll be there for the last 2 days of the GGX show, and then we'll be over on the next show for where everybody can come. So make sure you get your flights, your tickets, and can't even tell you what the dates are at the moment. I haven't got them off the top of my head, but
Oh yeah, good.
So yeah, get on that bandwagon and book the wrong times.
Well, it'll be all over our socials, and yeah, we'll post about it very soon. Yeah.
Keep an eye out.
And we'll have a calendar as well, remember?
Yeah.
For people can book appointments who want to purchase.
So yeah, we'll have definitely 45-minute appointments that I will spend all my time with you if you book an appointment, and we can talk Opal, and if you're interested in something to buy, I can definitely lead you in the right direction to finding the gem of your dreams. So yeah, come on, Don, you got to come. Come on, I know it's a bit of a drive, but you got to come anyway.
Yeah.
We got some really nice pieces today, and quite a few pieces to cut out. Some are very easy and some will be a little bit tricky. So yeah, Richard, only an hour away. Good stuff. Awesome. Yes. Oh, good point bringing up the floods around Lightning Ridge. We have flooding going on that has cut off a lot of Lightning Ridge. I did hear this morning, though, that a couple of people are driving out there, and I don't know what they're going to find, because when it's flooding out there, there's not a lot of mining going on. Mm. So there's not a lot of production, I would imagine, coming out of there at the moment. So, yes, thank you, Peter, from Hungary. That's very kind. Yeah. Oh, look at you. Oh, wow. There's so many of you already.
No.
And we haven't even started. Haven't even started cutting the real stuff. And I'm amazed nobody said, can you just get to the cutting and shut up?
Rude.
I'm being rude to myself. All right, well, I think we're gonna go in.
See ya.
We're gonna rock and roll.
Have fun.
So come over and yell a question if you see one that's worthy.
I will indeed.
Got my little sieve here of goodies that I reckon we'll cut some crackers.
There's one that I already picked
up. Really?
That's my favorite.
Is it green?
No. Oh. No, it's red.
Oh, that one. I was a bit more excited about the green one that it's in there. But anyway, Susan Turcotte. Yes, I am definitely going to be going in. So let me just set you up there so that you got a good bird's eye view. Oh, Katona fence. That's very kind of you. You adore us. Thank you. That's really, really kind. Awesome. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Oh, we're coming to the end of the year. Another year. Crazy. All right. We got close enough there. Maybe a little bit closer. Pecan tree reviews. That's very kind of you too. Thank you. From Brenham, Texas. Oh, I love Texas. I really do. It's one of the coolest states, I reckon. Okie dokie. Let's make sure that microphone's not hitting my beard. My stubble. All right. Let's have a quick look at what we've got here. This is what I call my favorite. Look at that color. Hopefully it comes clean with those sand spots in the face, but look at that. Yes, very cool. Anyway, I think this one is, where's Tamika's favorites here somewhere? No, not that one.
I can't see it.
She stole it. This one here, that one is Tamika's favorite.
Yeah.
So it does have some pretty nice color, and there's really not a lot I need to do to it except for just bring it in to its nice shape. Thin as paper it is.
Thin as my figure.
As my figure.
That.
As my figure. So yeah, we've got a few nice pieces. This one has a color bar that could get eaten by sand. I don't know it yet. This one here, look at the magic purples and blues. And it goes right across. I just need to clear that up. And maybe a nice potch on the back too. Maybe we cut something decent out of that. But needs to be cleaned up. So, and this one here too as well. This one's quite a cool piece. You could either Dremel this one, carve it, and make a funky carving, or you could be Justin and just smoothing it off and make a nice clean stone. Yes, I agree with the yummy comment. This one here also, beautiful play of color. That
yeah,
is
that's my second.
Your second, Tamika's second favorite piece here. Yes, so very, very nice pieces. And we got a bit of stuff to work on. There's the, look at that. That color's nice too. So it's not really a reveal on that one because it's already there. This piece here, I reckon we'll make a magnificent crystal once I clean it up a bit more. I reckon we'll get that real color on color, beautiful. I'll just turn that light down a smidgen because I know it's going to, oh, it's got a mind of its own, this light. Here we go, it's doing its own thing again. Anyway, let's get into it. So I'll get that wheel going. The reason why I push that wheel is just so that the belt doesn't squeak. It's the only reason, by the way, for people who wonder why I do that. This machine is starting to sound a little bit noisy. If I lift it off the table, yeah, it might get a little bit less noisy. Just hang on a sec. She's a bit vibrating too much. No, I've got these rubber stoppers. The rubber stoppers, after a while, they, hang on 1 second, guys, sorry. A little bit quieter. Not too much quieter, but that's all right. What's the question?
So, Kelsey saw a documentary video the other day and mentioned black rifles in other parts of the world.
Right.
I thought they were in Australia. Is the only difference that they're documentary?
Yes. Yeah. Correct. So the question was that there was a documentary that there was opals in other parts of the world, black opals, and what's the difference between the black opals in the other parts of the world and Australia, and that is that Australian opal is sedimentary, and it's the only place in the world that's sedimentary. The rest is volcanic. So that's the difference. So this stone is going to be crazy if it is clean. It's going to be just magnificent, and it's got the web lines in it that actually separate the color really beautifully. See that there? Is it a bit of fuzzy video? You might find that our internet is going in and out. It's fast and slow, so I do apologize if it gets a little bit fuzzy. Could you, Tamika, could you grab my other glasses, please? They're just right on the table there. And that way I'll be able to see a little bit better. Had to put my cutting glasses in. There we go. That's better. Now I can see everything. So I'm hoping now that I've shaped it that I can roll this sand out and we get a nice clean stone. Hopefully, without losing all that color. Whoa. So the problem here is I've got sand spots there and then the potch is starting to come up. So I don't really want to risk losing too much color. Even though you can see the color and it's already faced, there's still issues that you've got to avoid or try to tackle. On what looks like an easy cut, it doesn't end up being that easy. Yeah. Once you hit 40, I reckon everybody goes, oh, my eyes don't work as well as they used to.
So much
today,
how much the possible
was,
but these are all different.
Okay, yeah, so somebody's just asked, who was that? Was that a... Okay. Somebody's just asked how much this parcel cost, and this whole lot is a bunch of parcels put together now, so I don't really have a price on them anymore. I have an approximate value at the time, but then I put them into a little pile for YouTube, and so I don't really remember, so I apologize for that. But that is a magnificent gem that's going to be 4 carats. Beautiful pattern, so beautiful, beautiful gem. Really stoked with that.
Do you want a 1200 grit?
This is the 240 grit, 250 grit, sorry. Yeah. gorgeous, gorgeous stain. Look at that. Blue green most common. No, blue is most common. Purple is even more common. Green is not so common. All right, well, that's one down. What do we got here? Another green, blue. And I'm just going to take it around the edges where that sand is there. There's a big blob of sand there. How much a carat for that last stone, somebody just asked. That will be around about the $2,000, $1,500 to $2,000 a carat, depending on how it finishes off. Pecan tree, thank you very much. That was very kind of you. What's the rarest type of opal from Australia? And that will be black opal. That's for sure. And Caton Fence, thank you very much. Katona Fence. What is your dream opal color stone? One day, what was it? One day I'll buy an opal from you. Oh, that's very kind. Well, my favorite color for me personally is green like this. Can have a little bit more 3D color on color, but still green suits me. The most valuable is red, but yeah, I like greens for me, for my skin tone and my life. I love the wilderness, I love the ocean, so I love the greens and the blues because it reminds me of everything I love. So if you're a vampire, you'll like red because you like blood. I'm just kidding. That was a pretty bad analogy, but anyway, I'm just taking grinding the sand spots and the dips off the top of this piece, trying to find out where the cleaner area to the stone is, and it's looking pretty clean. That's like a wispy or a mossy pattern. There's still some sand spots here, here, and here, so I need to get them out.
Does black opal hold its value, or does it go up and down like gold?
The question was, does black opal hold its value, or does it go up and down like gold? Over the years, it's proven to go up and down, depending on markets and how big the market is. And when the Japanese bubble economy bursted back in the 80s, the price of opal plummeted because there was no market to sell to. There was a lot of opal around and nobody could sell it, so it became quite cheap. Right now, opal is quite expensive. And we have a bit of a conundrum now, because now there's not as much coming out of the ground as there was back in the 80s and 90s, that supply and demand is changed very differently. So it's a different animal at the moment, and I dare say that opal, we have a downturn in the economy, I think opal will hold its value, mainly because of it's really hard to get out of the ground, and supply is not like it was in the 80s and 90s. Magic stone, look how much better that turned out. Really nice piece. I'm happy with that. Very, very cool. Thanks, Don. I love it too. Phew!
What's that pattern?
Yeah, what pattern would you call that? Come on. Give me a pattern.
Everyone's nervous.
Oh, Don. Don first up with the old moss. Yeah, Shimoda, not quite chaff. I know what you're talking about. Well, there is a bit there, right there. There's a bit of chaff, but the most common occurrence of patterns in there. Pecan trees. What type of shape would you recommend for an anniversary gift for your wife? A shape?
Well, no.
If you watch my videos enough, you'll know that this shape here is my favorite type of shape.
But I love my horse.
but a love heart can be a very, very good shape. Well done, Tamika. That was a good call right there. Does everybody jigsaw? Smoke pattern. We've got smoke pattern, misty shape. We've got pin fire. This isn't pin fire, unfortunately. Sorry. This is closest to moss pattern. Yeah, you mostly got it right. Yeah. Nice. Dendric. Love it. Okay, well, there's another one down. Now, what do we got here? Oh, check out this little guy. There isn't much involved in cutting this stone, but the color is magnificent. Check out that. All I'm going to do just quickly is shape it up. It's a little stone, so it's harder to hold in the hands, and it won't take me long. But I should be able to get around about a carat out of it. And at $800 to $1,000 a carat, it ends up being quite a nice little gem. So this one was faced already by the miner, so you can see all it needed to do was to be shaped. That's pretty cool. Very bit directional. You can see there's some chaff pattern right there for the people who don't know what chaff is. And then you've got some, there's some chaff again, those lines. And then if you move it around, there you go. That's broad flash right there. Okay, good stuff. That was a good one. Next one, this is Tamika's favorite. Yeah. And that is some nice red blue right there. Oh, excuse me. And so all I'm doing right now is, because there's that dip on the side there and no color, I need to bring that in until I get that out. And the same goes for all the other areas as well. So I'll just bring that in a little bit until we start to see the color showing up, which is not quite there yet. Almost there. Yeah, so I'll just try rolling that edge and we're good to go, pretty much good to go. There's a little bit of residue, but nevertheless. So I'm going to make this one, even though it's more square, there's rounded sides to it, I'm going to make it a round. Nice round for a ring. So you only really need to get the approximate shape when I'm doing this preforming. When you're on the dop stick, you can really knuckle down and get that shape perfect. But right now, all I'm doing is getting it to its approximate shape. Take some of that back off. It doesn't need to be there. Beautiful. Look at that. Magic gem, that one. Really, really happy with that.
Beautiful. Someone asked, in your downtime,
yep,
do you do carving on Opal just for fun?
Do I? Somebody's just asked, in my downtime, do I do carving just for fun? And I think everybody else can kind of answer that for you. So if I do like carving, put a thumbs up. If I don't, put a thumbs down. And you guys who follow me quite well, quite often, will know that question. Lol, no. There's the first one. Lol, no. Am I a carver? Downtime meaning my rest time. Do I do carving? Aaron on the money. T-Boogs. Nope, Jojo. Yep, there we go. I don't do much Dremel carving. I do some every so often for a video, but if I can help it, you won't get me near a Dremel.
won't get me near it. But I will say though, at the moment we have the Dremel tips in stock that I used in the last Dremel video, and they're really good. There's a lot of diamond in them and they wear down so slowly. So if you compare them to other brands, they last heaps longer because of the diamond in them. So if you're looking for it, go into our website under Lapidarian Tools and you'll see them there. They're actually really, really good. A few sets have already been sold, but they only just came in a few days ago. Look at that little magnificent gem, eh? Look at that beautiful color. All right. No, you go fishing is the exact right answer. In my downtime, I love to fish. You're right. I love to make fish tacos. Van, you're exactly right there. Gorgeous gem. Happy with that. So this one is a nice piece as well, and depending on how much we get off that side depends on how big this is going to be. So I might just take some of that back off and make a little bit easier job. What's my favorite fish to fish? That would be barramundi in Darwin, in the Northern Territory. We have a fish called barramundi, and they're a really beautiful eating fish as well as quite fun and visually exciting to catch.
Someone wants to know, does Opal lose color and quality over time, especially if it's wet, especially in sunlight?
Question was, does Opal lose color and quality over time, especially if it's left in the sunlight? And the answer to that is, a good quality opal won't change at all. It won't change, but there is some types of opal that can kind of bleach in the sunlight, and it only bleaches in like about a half a millimeter to a little bit less than a millimeter. And yes, and you can recut it and it all turns dark again or bright, but not very often. No, I wouldn't say that that's something that happens, that's a common occurrence with opal. Other types of opal from overseas, I don't know. I only know really about that with Australian opal. But it's not like, there's turquoise, is it topaz? Turquoise can lose its color, I think, in the direct light over time. There's a few other gemstones. Someone else might be able to pipe up and say, tell the world. Topaz, there you go, topaz. You can tell that I'm not an expert in anything other than opal, because I really don't know my other gemstones very well at all. So you want to embarrass me, ask me another gemstone question, and I'll go, I can hear my mum calling, I've got to go. Hey, I want your honest opinion too. In the last video, I did the goopiest entrance for the intro, and I want to know whether you thought it was dumb or whether you thought it was funny and good. Let me know. If you haven't seen it, you'll have to go have a check it out, but I'd love your opinion on what you thought of it. Beautiful gem. Look at that. Funny, good, funny, funny. Love Morganite. Forgot, sorry, you forgot, Don. I liked it, funny, dumb, thank you.
Cheesy.
Yep, I wanted you to be honest, cheesy. It was 50-50. My goodness, liked it, always funny, 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 funny. Baha, it was funny. It was pretty much modeled off the office, the show, The Office. because yeah, the American office, because Steve's quite funny, we think in this office. So this is a piece of pretty much a piece of bone, or yeah, probably bone, fossilized bone, but I'm going to cut it because there's not enough shape to it to really justify it being bone or a specimen. So I'm just going to see what I can get out of there. Whoa, look at that little bit of color that just popped up the top there. Look at that. Don't you love that? Oh, bit by bit, let's hope that this cleans up, because that color is ridiculous. Crikey, I agree. Rocky Mountain, crikey. It's my favorite word. Whoa, stop it. Look at that color. Wow. Oh, this could be really, really nice. You see that sand spot also looks like it should come out. This is a little bit of a surprise piece. I wasn't expecting that. Little achiever there in the background. Look at you go, look at that color. Holy dooly, bling bling, that's for sure. Yes, I am going in, and it's really working this time. Oh, wow. Oh, Tamiki, come and check this out. You got to see this color. Look at that.
It's amazing.
That is incredible.
Dancing.
It's dancing, yep. It's what we call happy opal. Because it looks at you and it's happy. Wow. I love it when a piece that looks kind of not that great and it turns out to be something special. It's like the opposite to when you see under this shirt that I'm wearing, this dad bod. It's not something special. Oh dear. Okay, I went there, didn't I? All right, check out this. There we go. What a magnificent gem. I can get that little white spot outside too. Bob Ross, thank you. I always like the Bob Ross comments. They're very complimentary, and I appreciate it. But I got to talk a bit slower and move with the opal and work with the lines. And there we have it, the most beautiful gem. Like Mother Nature's painted a picture. I'm just going to stop that. Alrighty, check this one out. Beautiful color, magnificent, and I'm just going to make it pretty much the shape it's in. Happy little trees, yes! Oh, I love it. I love it. You guys get me. You guys definitely get me. Hey, I mentioned romper room the other day and you guys got me. It's pretty crazy.
Someone asked,
what's the best opal to practice cutting on?
I mean, I guess if you graduated from potch.
Yeah, if you've worked on potch, just plain opal with no color, which is probably best for working and practicing shapes. Yeah, if you buy some potch and colour from somebody, it's a really good place to start, that's for sure. Look at that beauty. Oh, wow, that is gorgeous. What a stone. Hey, it's a shark fin, hey? Put a snorkel on it, there's my shark fin. Very cool. Oh, I like that. That's beautiful. Hey, we're getting some really nice stones out today. Really nice pieces. This one's going to be beautiful too. Oh, wow. Beautiful. So there's no color here and very little chance of getting anything out right there. So Oh, nice, Amiga. that's great. So I'll just take in the sides that has the sand that we don't need, or we can't get a stone out of there. Pucker, wow. Yeah, I agree with that. So our stone is really pretty much here. That's where our beautiful gem is. This is Poch. So if I just do a sneaky trim here, take that corner off like that and go on the other side, just make a little groove like a glass cutter does. So I've made that little groove. This saves me going on the slicer, and then I just snap it off. Done. So there is a little stone there, very small one, and I can work on that one a little bit later. But what I'm going for is this color. Let me see the colors. Look at the colors. Whoa. All right, while I'm rubbing this up, tell me what pattern is it. You tell me what pattern is that.
You tell me what
pattern.
I know.
I know. Oh, somebody's got the hand up. I can see you. Yeah. Oh, yes. We're getting there. Yep. I like jigsaw. I don't think jigsaw is an actual pattern, really. I don't know. Because most opals are jigsawed, the patterns jigsawed together. So, yeah. See, yes, we definitely need to make another pattern video. From what I'm seeing, Alison, I like that you wrote flag, but flag and flagstone are two different patterns, just letting you know. So, if you want to reframe your wording, you'll be correct. So yes, the answer is this is flagstone. There was a couple of flakes of color that looked like it could be clover leaf, but it's the closest thing it is to is flagstone. So nice work, Barrett Hart, funny man. It's not Harlequin. Harlequin doesn't exist. It does, but I'm just gonna pretend it doesn't, because so many people use the word on everything that, yeah. Harlequin is the unicorn of opal. Just shaping this one up. I think I've got it pretty much to where the best color sits. I can give that a bit more of a shape, more of a curve. Or sand spot still has to come in. It's showing up on the side too much. Oh, that's really not good. Then I'm misshaping it because I've had to get that out. Anyway, now we bring it in a little bit smaller, so be it. It's only lost half a carat. And then we re-smoothing and even out the back. Magic. Look at the magic. So yes, the answer to that is flagstone. Beautiful. Beautiful gem. And this one's considered a dark opal. So it's not a black opal. It's not a white opal. It's halfway in between. Beautiful. It is a nice parcel tonight, AM. So this little guy, don't underestimate these little guys. Little tiny knobby that could sit at the bottom of a bucket that you don't really consider, that could be a $500 to $1,000 gem. Don't discount them. So let's see what we get out. We smoothen those edges, all that rough exterior, and see what goes on the inside. Let's find out its true personality. Personality. Sorry. Oh wow, this is going to be gorgeous, this stone. This is my type of opal. Seriously. Never discount these little guys. They're just magnificent color. Always love it when I get a little clean skin knobby like this, and all you need to do is just clean off the skin around the edges, and it turns into a beautiful color on color gem. Look at that. Is that not magnificent? Look at that. Why is red more valuable? The reason why red is more valuable is because it's the most rare color that comes out of the ground. That is why. That is gorgeous. I think we're like winner winner chicken dinner, all right. We haven't had a dud yet. No Dudleys, all winners. So this piece is the last piece, and you can see it's got a gray skin, but I believe that if we take that down, there's gonna be some nice electric color, I'm hoping. Nice earring, yes, Don, I agree. So let's just start taking that top off and get down to the color. Want to get a good idea of that color. I need to go past the cloud to get to the nice color. See, it's a nice dark blue. Sand spots in that side don't do it any justice, so that's all got to come out. You can see that. So we can go further. Further till it's out, almost out. There it is. There's the color bar. I'll leave that for a second and start on the other edges and see where we're at. I have to bring that in still a little bit further. All right, now I can start to roll this side to get those sand spots out. I might have to bring it in a little bit further to get them out properly. We need to bring in that side too. So nice stone. This has put a bit of a spanner in the works to get the perfect cushion cut that I want. And I'm gonna have to roll that more, but I want a nice high dome because this side's got a nice high side to it, and that doesn't because of the sand spot. So if I bring it in just a little bit more, I'll get a little bit more of a balanced gem out of it, I think. So we just take it in a smidgen more and then roll that edge and get that sand spot out. Here we go, she's out. Roll that out. 250 grit. And then we even up that back, and that's going to turn out to be quite a nice little skim too. Roll that. The reason why I'm smoothing the sharp edges on the back is so that when I put it on the dop stick, it makes it a lot easier to glue it to the stick, get strength, and also when I take it off, I won't chip the back edges. So look at that beautiful purpley blue. And with a little bit more light, let's see if we can get a bit more light on it, you'll see the colors that I'm talking about. There we go. Nice. Let's turn that back down a little bit again so that we don't get the light turning off. But anyway, there we go. That's very nice. Very nice. Let's have a good look at these stones. That was awesome. I'm very happy with that. I mean, there was a lot of stones that didn't have a lot of risk in it this time around. It's 11:14 a.m. It is. 3:14 a.m. Oh, wow. Well, I'm very chuffed that you're staying up that late to watch on, unless you're just naturally a vampire or a bat. Beautiful jam. This is Tamika's favorite. You. She's dancing in the background. As soon as I show that one, she goes, yeah, unce. A beautiful stone. This one's gorgeous little, gorgeous little cushion cut. Still has a little bit of a dip that I need to work on. Let's see if I can,
light has just got a mind of its own. There we go. All right, that one's nice. This one was one of the last ones we worked on. We figured it was flagstone, which is very pretty. And a lot of player color, from reds, orange, greens to blues, everything in there. You just invested in a Genie 6-inch. Nice, I love it, well done. This is probably my favorite stone of the morning. It's a bit bigger than I imagined it would be. It may be coming a bit smaller with that sand spot there. Depends on how easily I can roll it out before I hit the potch on the back. But still, even if it comes into there, it's still going to be a very pretty gem. So very happy with that. This one is a lot bigger than I thought it would be and a lot brighter. And we decided that that was moss pattern. What was that, Tamika?
Nothing.
Another nice stone. See, we got all winners today. All winners. It's pretty cool to be the second. Oh, this one was the show of the day, actually. Still sand spot there, but that's just surface and it will come out.
Birdie.
That is gorgeous. Gorgeous gem. So much depth and color on that one. Oh, yeah. This was the last one we did, the cushion cut. That will polish up quite nicely. Magnificent drop or free form. Great green and blue play of color in that one. So good. And lucky last couple. This one here with nice broad flash there, and then there's that really cool chaff pattern in there as well. So we will be doing another pattern video, explaining a little bit more. And this is the little knobby that was just a little surprise. You know, don't discount these guys. This is gorgeous, gorgeous crystal. And I will polish a beautiful 3D color on color gem out of that. So very cool. And we are nearing the end. So I appreciate you guys coming around for another sesh. We have one more live coming before the end of the year. Let me get my other glasses because I can't see much in distance with them. Nancy, you're absolutely so welcome. Good fishing. I'm not going to get much fishing in for the next couple of weeks. I'm heading over to Perth for my grandmother's 80th.
Grandmother's?
My mother-in-law's.
Gosh.
Sorry, Mum.
Sorry,
mother,
Patty.
Mother outlaw.
If Patty's watching.
Yeah, she usually watches. She's my favourite fan. You know, my mother-in-law, whenever I put a video out, she texts me that morning and tells me what she thinks of the video. She loves it.
You're so sweet.
It's very cool. Yeah, I'm in the doghouse, David. You're right. She's going to... No, she forgives me for everything I do. very cool.
But you will be fishing before Christmas.
Oh!
Yes, your little trip.
Yes, we have a very... it's been planned for over a year now. We're going... My son, Saxon, and I, we're going up to the top end of Australia where those barramundi that I was talking about just before. We're going to go and catch some beautiful fish. So
very exciting.
Saxon's loving his videoing and editing at the moment, so he'll make a great video so you guys will be able to see that trip if you're even remotely interested. If you're not, don't bother. Darwin area, yes.
Yeah.
We're actually going to Coburg Peninsula, which is Croker Island, and we'll be staying on a boat out there. Fantastic fun.
Yeah.
Yep. So Nancy Buchanan from Michigan, welcome. Mm-hmm. Good to see you here. All right. Yeah, fishy, fishy. No four-wheel driving. It's all on a mothership. Yes, and it is Arnhem Land. A lot of you guys know a lot about that place up there. Good to see.
Magnificent.
It's one of the most beautiful parts of the world.
Arnhem Land is just fascinating. Mm. Yeah, it's beautiful. They're very lucky.
Mm.
A beautiful
Actually,
country.
The best place, the best site in the world for me is the wetlands just after the wet season in Darwin or up around Darwin. There's one place that we drive a boat up to and it's all green swamp. There's crocodiles everywhere. There's snakes and beautiful, beautiful bird life.
Mm.
and you just turn the engine off and you sit there and you listen to the birds, and it's the most beautiful experience of your life, being magic. In nature like that. But then anyway, yes,
something to look forward to.
I can't better the size of the barramundi. I've caught my biggest barramundi of my life. It was 121 centimeters, biggest fish I've ever caught, and that won't be, I'll never catch another one like that. Pretty cool. All right, we're out of here.
Yeah,
thanks for joining us, appreciate it. Keep an eye out for the video next week.
It's gonna be a fun one.
This is a little hint. Take care.
You will love the next video.
You will love it. Join you guys.